President-elect Joe Biden wants 100 million vaccines given in his first 100 days, which I believe in my math would be about a million a day. Am I right? Right around a million a day. It's part of a $1.9 trillion American Rescue Plan. About $400 billion of that is going to be on things aimed at controlling the virus control, and he breaks it out from there. But this is extremely aggressive from PCS Advisors. That's a healthcare consultancy. Paul Siegert's on the show this morning to talk about the impact on business and, well, America in general. Paul, good morning. How are you?
Great. How are you, Scott?
I'm doing fine. Thanks for joining. So the question isn't $1 million. Can we do a million shots a day? Is that possible?
Well, according to the supply chain, we can supply that many. Whether we can administer them is a whole other thing. And I think that would be an amazing feat if we were able to accomplish that.
It would be man on the moon levels, but here's the problem we have right now. We can't distribute the vaccines we have on the shelf now.
Right. We've got Operation Warp Speed saying they've distributed 32 million and yet, say, between 13 and 15, best we can tell, have been actually administered. So there's basically as many different plans to administer the vaccine as there are states and jurisdictional areas, vaccination programs. There's 64 of those. So it's being handled very differently.
Yeah, a lot of people have heard about, hey, we have the vaccines, we just can't get them to the people we need. Talk about the bureaucracy behind that for those that aren't really understanding why we have vaccines that people aren't getting. And in the case of New York State, they're having to throw them out because they've expired. What's going on here?
Yeah, there's a lot of confusion. They're throwing them out because they've expired, and yet you see the governor of that state going direct to Pfizer and trying to negotiate the ability to purchase more while that's happening. So you've got, I think with any campaign this large, it's expected there would be some bumps in the road. And you've got this top-down program of recommending by the CDC who should get it and in what order. But those are really just recommendations. Then each state, at least under Operation Warp Speed in the Trump administration, was responsible for taking it from there, taking the ball, running with it, and getting the shots in people's arms. And you've seen wildly different results when it comes to that based on the states. You've got some that have a pretty high percentage of their population already vaccinated, some that are leading the way, like West Virginia. Everyone in a care home in West Virginia has been vaccinated. And then you have other states that are lagging way behind based on their ability to get that job done. So with what Biden's proposing is that he would activate FEMA and the National Guard and put up thousands of centers all in the first month around the country, which would be pretty darn aggressive.
Yeah. Never underestimate the power of government to screw things up, I guess is what you're saying. Is it? How is it? I remember we talked a while ago, Paul Siegert, about this issue, and my thought was, okay, we've got this vaccine, the first one out anyway, where it's got an extremely short shelf life. It has to be refrigerated. Each vial has 100 doses. I said that works really well in places like, well, New York or Ohio, but go to, I don't know, West Virginia, where it's extremely mountainous. People live in the hollers out there. They're tucked away. You may have 5 or 6 or 7 families in one area and then have to, you know, drive across the other side of the mountain in order to distribute the vaccine, even if you can get a hold of them. And I said, wow, rural areas are really going to have a hard time getting this out. And but here we are. It's completely flipped around. New York, you got the problems, and West Virginia is fine.
Yeah, you have bureaucratic issues. I think in the larger those states, perhaps there's some sense to that, or some we can maybe understand that. But it is pretty surprising that some of these states like West Virginia, South Dakota, Louisiana, Alaska, they're leading. They're ahead of states like California and New York in getting this job done.
Have we changed it, Paul, in that I know that the British have said, hey, listen, instead of sitting there and holding on to, for every two vaccines we have, we're going to release one, and then we're going to hold a vaccine back for that person so they can get their second immunization. The British said, we're going to use all of them first and wait, let the supply chain catch up. That seems to be working better, and it sounds like maybe we've turned the corner on that, decided, okay, that's going to be the best way to do this.
We have. The Operation Warp Speed came out and said they're going to go ahead and release vaccines that they've been holding back. They did do that after the incoming Biden administration said they would kind of change that policy. Now, in kind of one point of difference between what we're doing, at least at this point, as compared to the UK and some other places around the world, they are releasing, in the UK, they're releasing all the vaccines, getting first doses in people's arms. And with the expectation that they may not get those people back in for a second dose at the recommended interval, according to what was approved in the studies that supported it. And that's, that's yet to be seen if that will be as effective. And, you know, it's a fairly large gamble. Whereas here we're releasing all the vaccines for first doses, and we've got reassurance from the supply chain, from Pfizer and from Moderna. Between the two, we've got 500 million doses that are supposed to be available by June, July.
Okay.
So we've got assurances from them that those will be there for that second dose on time.
Paul Siegert is with PCS Advisors, healthcare consultant, and talking about Biden's very aggressive 100-day plan here, including the $1.9 trillion American Rescue Plan. We'll also get into the paying for that aspect in a little bit. But obviously, it's a lot of this is focused on getting the shots out, right? And instead of holding back a second dose, you can give twice as many first doses this way, which is definitely the way to go, in my opinion, because I was looking at efficacy rates. After the first injection, once obviously takes effect, it has something like an 80% efficacy rate. The second dose only adds another 15% to that. So you go from 80 to 95. It's better to have more people protect 80% to 80% success rather than a smaller group with 95%. So I get the math on that.
Yeah, absolutely. Now we've got, and you're going to get it herd immunity through vaccinations. That's the quicker and obviously less deaths. It's a better way to go. And then you've got people that actually get infected. And we've had officially 24 million of those. I was kind of running some of this math early this morning, and likely many more have been exposed that were not, asymptomatic. But even if we went with the 24 million number and then looked at the amount of vaccines that we'll have available that are projected to be able to be distributed by June, July, that 500 million number, cut that in half, you're at 250 that could be given both doses. That gets us to 70% of our population is 230 million. 80% is around 275 million, which is where that would get us. And we're hearing that 80% mark could be herd immunity. So we have the vaccines, and now it's just getting it in people's arms. And it's not just a distribution problem. I think Biden's got a plan to address that at a more national level, and we'll see how well that rolls out, because it is a huge undertaking with FEMA, National Guard, and so on. And hiring, part of that, he's proposed hiring 100,000 social educators to go to communities and encourage people to take the vaccine.
Because you got to convince people to do that, especially in rural and poor communities are, for whatever reason, reluctant to roll up their sleeve and get the vaccine. So you need people out there to actually to tell them what's good for them. Sad, but that's true, right? The other element of this thing, too, Paul, we talked about the vaccine and what's in the supply chain, but the president-elect did not mention any plans whatsoever to ramp up testing availability. That's a bigger one to me. We have people going out and essentially doing their own exam, where I've known people going to the pharmacy for their rapid test, and they're instructing them how to stick the Q-tip up their nose, which is not the best way to do it because you're reluctant to hurt yourself, obviously, and I don't know if you're getting a good sample there. As a matter of fact, one person I know did it and pretended to stick it all the way up there. So you're wasting a test, in my opinion, there. And there's someone who may have been positive, and you wouldn't know because you didn't do it right.
Yeah, testing is a huge part of how we could manage this whole thing better when we look at examples around the world where they're having less severe outbreaks. Testing is a huge component. While they're getting the vaccine out, if they're doing these rapid tests, that's part of the plan to open schools. There were three big priorities that Biden came out with. Everyone wear in this first 100 days, everyone wears a mask, 100 million doses that we've talked about, and then reopening the majority of schools, the K-8 schools. And to accomplish that would require lots of testing and accurate testing, to your point.
All right, so we need to open up testing and get more people to figure out, where this is. Because I think many more people are infected that don't know it. Would you agree?
Absolutely. Yeah, that's a huge part of what's going on that's causing this surges that we keep seeing.
Yeah, and you get herd immunity, you won't have to worry about that as much anymore. But right now, to me, that's really what we should have been doing all along. As far as distribution goes, though, this is going to be an interesting model, as you pointed out, because now you're going to federalize this whole thing. Why couldn't the pharmacies and the like have handled this? And I know some areas are different than others, and each state is different, too. As I think the state of Ohio's website, for example, for going in and getting this stuff is it's clunky at best and non-functioning at worst. But as far as that element of it goes, what is this going to look like? Are going to be rolling to, you know, federal buildings and you know, Paul Brown Stadium, Great American Ballpark for our shots? How's this going to look?
Well, they're going to have thousands of centers that they will set up that are federally supported and use the National Guard and FEMA to get those propped up. So it could be any number of ways that they get that accomplished. They said they'll have 100 in the first month with the goal of thousands. And they will also enlist pharmacies, as you mentioned. And pharmacies are involved in the efforts currently. They've been primarily focused on nursing facilities for the elderly. Mm-hmm. So they're getting vaccines already, and the intention is to widen make it possible for somebody like us to show up or somebody in a qualified group. And they're also expanding those that are recommended to get the vaccine now. Anybody 65 plus and in those essential groups like teachers and those in the food industry, et cetera.
Yeah. In each state, obviously, is a little bit different. Like Kentucky and Indiana are about 10 years ahead of us. That makes sense. This past week, we're doing 80-year-olds. They're on to 70 already.
That's right. It's interesting to watch this roll out. That's not like anybody projected.
Yeah, that's true. When do you think it's all going to catch up, when it starts to become critical mass, where it functions like, you know, we would expect it to?
Well, just based on when the vaccines will be available, I'm going to be optimistic and say that we'll get it figured out in terms of getting the vaccines more quickly administered. Well, that's one component. Educating people to deal with the hesitancy is another big factor. And you still have areas of the country where a majority of healthcare professionals are hesitant to get vaccinated. And if that's true for healthcare professionals, what about the rest of the population? Mm-hmm. So there's certainly work to do there. And then when will we actually have the vaccines to administer? So between Pfizer and Moderna, plus the portion of our population that's already been infected, it seems like the numbers would support herd immunity as so long as we get them in people's arms. And I think we're back to what we were talking about in prior conversations, because those won't be released. 150 million and 100 million of the Moderna vaccines, 150 million of Pfizer, 100 million of Moderna, those are June and July deliveries. So we won't have those until June or July at the federal level to get then distributed throughout the country.
I feel like I'm in a race trying not to get COVID before the shot. I'm like, okay, I'm wearing a mask. I'm socially, I'm trying to do what I can do here. All the best. Is like, man, I hope I don't get it before I get the vaccine. Even after the vaccine, it's going to take a good couple weeks for it to take effect, like any vaccine.
Right, and I think there's a lot of us that are thinking, I wonder if I already had it. I feel like I had a bad flu at such and such a point. I hear that multiple times a day from folks. Mm-hmm. So we don't really know how many have already had it.
Well, my brother had it, very healthy guy in his late 40s, and he's had to go to the cardiologist because he's having abnormal EKGs. And they're like, yeah, it's kind of the permanent. I don't think there's any long-term. They said there's probably like no long-term damage, but it changes. So anything that changes the pattern of your heartbeat, very concerning.
Scary stuff.
Right? No kidding.
Without a doubt.
Paul Siegert, PCS Advisors, healthcare consultancy, with some updates here relative to Biden's $1.9 trillion plan, the America Rescue Plan. Thanks again, buddy. Be well. We'll talk again soon.
Thanks for having me, Scott. Yep.